Hello everyone out there in the Lucksack Legion, Alex here with Lucksack Games, and last time on Dragon Ball Z, we beat someone, and it felt good. So now, it's time to see if we can get in a few more wins. So let's start by taking a peek at our team. We've got Kid Jito, King Kai with his hat off, and Grandpa Gohan. Currently, our best Pokemon, or our best fighter. Oh my god, look at Grandpa Gohan's stats. Have I been underestimating Grandpa Gohan all along? Look at his stats. Dear god, those are really good. Alright, well. Anyways, Grandpa Gohan, King Kai, Kid Jito. We're going to go ahead and heal up and see if we can take on that bug trainer. Whee! Alright, so, for those of you that are tuning in, if this is your first episode, go watch the other ones. Do it. They're awesome. But, this is a fan-made game that's a hack of Pokemon Infinite Fusion where you can fuse together any two fighters. Our goal for this episode will be to beat another trainer or two. So let's go ahead and go take on that bug trainer that... I'd love to take on the one that's right here, but he has a Pokemon or a fighter with Swords Dance. And I think it's Fury Attack, and we're just not beating that. At least not yet. Alright, first fight of the episode. Let's see who we're against. The older version of ourselves. I think we can take this thing down. I'm not scared of no Twister anymore. Thunder Wave's annoying, but remember we have Shed Skin, so that's not nearly as bad as it could be. See? Didn't even last a turn. See, that was a great fight. That was a great fight. Alright, let's go. Wake me up before you go. What's this? Ooh, a capsule. I'll take free capsules. Alright, is there any way? Oh my god, there is a way to dodge him. No, there isn't. As soon as we step here, it's going to initiate a battle. Oh well. Hey, look at my cool bug fighter. Which one's the bug? SSJ4 Renouncer. I will say that's kind of a cool name, that his name is Renouncer. Because he's, you know, renouncing or whatever. Alright, does Astonish hit you? Are you a normal type? Astonish does hit you. Fabulous. Alright, so we're going to Astonish out this thing. Leers don't matter as much because we'll be able to swap out in between fights. Sheesh, with how good this fight's going, it's a wonder we ever even lost, right? Didn't even take a point of damage. Grew to level 11. We're learning Twister. Alright, that's where this is at. That's where it's at. Alright, Power Pole. Bye. It's a shame, because I love having the new techniques. I think it's so cool that there's new moves in this game. But I mean, Power Pole is just so bad. Bugly. Yes. No. We're not going to swap out. We're going to start with a Thunder Wave. And then I think I'm going to see how much damage a Twister does. Sing didn't hit us all last time we fought this trainer. Hits us the first time. Shed Skin's so good. I'm just going to try and Twister out. I'm pretty sure Twister has a flinch chance too. I am not the best Pokemon trainer in the world. Not close. I have this movie poster behind me. It's awesome. Does not make me any better of a trainer. Saibata. Alright, so yes. This is the thing that only has Leech Seed as its only attacking move. So, we're going to try and get a poison off on it. So, every turn that it uses a Tail Whip or a Sand Attack or... What the actual heck is that? Back-to-back criticals? This thing destroyed my team last time. And we're going to knock it out in potentially three hits. All right. There's the leech seed. Now that's the Cybata I know. Poison? Poison? Not quite that lucky. Is King Kai going to get there? I'm going to feel so upset if King Kai just gets there. So, the initial plan of sending in King Kai is if we can just get him poisoned, then the poison damage will finish off Cybata. Because we found out that it is a grass normal type last time we fought, and grass normal does not resist poison at all. I'm going to keep in King Kai just on the off chance that Poison Sting finishes off Cybata. But, oh, there's the poison. Yes! Yes! Oh, it's gonna survive because of the leech seed. That's fine. I'm gonna try one more hit at this. Get him. Pew! Dead. Wow. Good job, King Kai. Maybe in spite of your stupid hat, we'll keep you on the team. No, how could this happen? Dude, I'm as lost as you are. Well, it was a good battle. Do you want to have another one? I did not just hit yes. I did hit yes, didn't I? I so did. Alright. Rematch. I guess... Since that only does one damage apiece, and it seems to be its main move, we'll just twister this thing out without having to worry about the paralysis. Crit? It's the last turn of crit matters. Eh, no crit. That's fine. Finish him, Kid Jiddo. Kind of reminds me of Kaijudo. Anyone else remember that game? Yeah, me either. Okay, I kind of do. I never played Kaijudo, for the record. I've played a lot of card games. I have Yu Yu Hakusho cards here. I have Naruto cards over there. I have Magic cards, Yu-Gi-Oh cards, Pokemon cards. But I've never played Kaijudo. For the record, I have played Duel Masters, which from what I've been told is Kaijudo before it was rebranded. But no, my oldest son, Alex, trying to learn Bite. Yes, please. Yes, please. Get this trash bug move out of here. My oldest son, Alex, which I'm also Alex, so he's obviously Alex Jr., wants to learn how to play the Pokemon game. He actually managed to beat Pokemon Sword basically by himself. Very, very little help from me on the last fight because he had trouble beating that Charizard. He said, I want to learn how to play the Pokemon cards. So I've been teaching him because how he was playing it was basically a war style. Whichever Pokemon had the higher hit points was the winner. Which meant that, you know, fully evolved Pokemon, GXs, etc. were just always the winners. But then at daycare, he played against another kid that was a little bit older. And the older kid was like, you're playing Pokemon all wrong. And it got my son all upset. And he's like, I don't want to play it the wrong way, Dad. I want to learn how to play it the right way. My oldest son is 6 for reference. So he's like, I need to know how to play it the right way so that I can beat Blake. And I said, that's perfectly fine. So we sat down, I helped teach him some of the rules, how prizes work, how you attack at the end of your turn, 1 energy per turn. He still forgets that you draw at the start of every turn, because he starts every turn and he goes, all right, I want to equip my energy and attack you. And it's like, start by drawing a card, kid. But no, he's having a great time. And you know what? I'm a very proud father. I could not ask for a better set of kids. My youngest son is almost 3, and he's not so much into Pokemon or cards or anything of that nature yet. He's more into Paw Patrol and, you know, monster trucks. Oh, thank God. If he asked me to battle once again, I guarantee you I would have misclicked and hit yes. Alright, let's... Oh, is this a Voltorb? Well, it can't be a Voltorb in this game. Alright, I think I clicked on it, so is it just a King Kai? King Kai gave shit for experience, so we're gonna go ahead and skip it. Oh, cool, an antidote. Aha, dodge that trainer. Toa. Alright, now Toas give pretty good experience, if I remember correctly, so we're gonna actually try and bite this one. See how much damage that does. Woohoohoo! Get a good move, start winning. Seems great. Feels amazing, man. Feels amazing. Alright, well, our moveset definitely went from one move that was absolutely miserable to use to three of our moves potentially flinch. So that's great. That's just great. Alright, we probably have to battle here. That's fine. Bug Fighter are totally great. Let me show you what they can do. Alright. Two fighters. Let's go. Goal Future. Goal! Yeah, sorry for all of you that are wearing headphones. So this is a Goku Trunks, it looks like. Let's try a bite, see what that does. Flinches. Alright, flinching's good. Flinching's great. Peck. Alright, so... interesting. That body does not look much like a Trunks, but it says Future. Androlong. Well, that's obviously an android of some sort. That is an Oolong Android 16, calling it right now. Alright, let's give it a bite, see what that does. Just a normal effectiveness on that, that's fine. Oolong Android 17, or Android 16, that's great. Android 16 is the one from the Cell Saga, for those of you that don't remember. No, how could this happen? Oh wait. Supposed to talk with trainers after we defeat them in case there's a chance they give us something neat. So we're gonna knock out every Toa we find because they give great experience. And wow, we went from never being able to beat a trainer to beating two in one episode. Yeah, let's do it again. This time it was not a misclick, this time I meant to re-challenge this trainer. Alright, send out your goal. Goal! Yeah, that is definitely a female model. Oh, maybe the first half isn't Goku like I thought. Maybe it's another female character, and that's why Trunks as the second half is fine. Alright, Androlong. So this is Oolong. I'm gonna try and hit it with a twister, see if that's super effective or anything. Nope. Nope, sure isn't. I'm not going to hit it with Astonish since there's a non-zero amount. Actually, now that I think about it, if Fairy type exists in this, then it was kind of silly to go for Twister too. Because there's a chance it would have been a Fairy type, and then it would have completely resisted it. That's right, I am way too strong for you. Don't you forget it. Balm mushrooms are super rare and super valuable. But be careful if you go looking... if you go hunting after them, they look the exact same as poison mushrooms. Can we die? Like, Goku's kind of known for eating things. Like, everything's. Whew, made it to the next town. Never thought it would happen. So freaking excited. Alright, get our fighters restored. Let's talk to this kid. That's how you're looking at my Tyrog. I'll trade you for a Mankey. Do we have... okay, we do not have a Mankey. Oh yeah, it devolves into a different fighter depending on what you fused it with, excuse me? Upstairs is the Trade Center. Ooh, alright, we'll take a peek at that. With enough training, you can defeat Brock. I mean, that Rattata's gonna need a lot of training to defeat Brock. I tried to battle Brock so many times, but he's just so tough. I have to keep coming back here to heal my fighter. If it makes you feel any better, it basically teleports you there. The more Dragon Balls you get, the more Wonder Trades you're allowed to make. Oh, that makes sense. Hello, I'm the Update Man. Is there anything I can help you with? All good. All good. You have to get a gym Dragon Ball before you're allowed to make a Wonder Trade. Alright. Gotta beat Brock first, that seems fair. Alright, I can't remember if we healed. Small brain and all that. We did. Hey, is that guy there all the time? Because I don't think we talked to him. Pure Series bigger, and therefore the center is busier. That makes sense to me. Do you check out the museum? Nope. Entrance is free, and there's a huge collection of rare fossils. Nice. Yawn, when Jigglypuff sings, fighters get drowsy. I guess it works on humans too. Well, I mean, half the fighters are human, right? What? Mount Pilaf is at Mount Moon? Huh? I'm on the phone. Scram. Team Pilaf, huh? Remember how I was mentioning Pilaf? Alright, who are you? Psst, do you know what I'm doing? No. I'm spraying Repel to keep Fighter out of the garden. Here, try it yourself. Ah, thanks for the Repel. Is it like a can of mace? Like, go away, Fighter. Tss, ah, my eyes. That's what kind of sounded like you were doing. Would you like to rent a room? No, thank you. $50 is kind of pricey when there's a free Pokemon Center, and I don't exactly, you know, sleep. Ooh, what are you guys here doing? I need your help. I lost my revival sentient on a bench earlier and I'm worried sick. I'll never be able to defeat Brock without it. Sure, I'll take a peek for it. It's gotta be somewhere in Pewter City for sure. Sure. Bug-type fighter, my favorite. I want to become a strong challenger using only bugs. Could you show me a fully evolved bug-type? I'll give you something cool if you do. I don't know if... Oh, so Gohan does not evolve again and neither does Kai. Alright, cool. Whoa, it's so big, it's like the ultimate bug fighter. Here, I want you to have this. Runtime error doesn't sound so good. Yeah, no one here can see this, but it says runtime error. I think we just crashed. We did. Alright. Well, that's a big sad. I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. I'm going to go ahead and get us back to Pewter City before the next episode. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. Alex here with Lucksack Games, reminding you to like, comment, subscribe. And next time on Dragon Ball Z, we'll get back where we were already. Peace.